Hey interior designers, welcome back to Design Inc. I'm Joanne, an interior designer and interior design business coach. If you're new here, I help you to start up and refine your interior design business with smart strategies and skills. In this video, we're diving deep into how AI technologies, specifically generative AI, is revolutionizing the interior design industry. Before we get into it, make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss out on future insights. Have you ever wondered what AI actually is? It's a subset of machine learning and it can create content like images, models, and even texts. I've checked out many AI tools available in the design industry and they focus on five main areas. Generative AI, visual reality and augmented reality, machine learning for personalized recommendations, predictive analysis for design trends, and finally, streamlined communication and project management. In this video, I'm going to explore each of these areas. First up, generative AI. This is probably the one that you are most familiar with. So how does AI work? AI uses neural networks to learn from data and to make predictions or even create new content. First, you tell the AI app what you want to do and it will trawl its machine learning and give you an answer. You'll be familiar with ChatGPT and Bard, for example. So let's take a look at how ChatGPT responds to a prompt. Let's say we're looking for items to include on a schedule for furniture for a 5-bedroom house. Pretty impressive, right? This type of AI is getting more and more clever at sounding like a human. However, you have to check the information for inaccuracies. Another thing to consider is copyright. Some media companies, such as the New York Times, are closing off their vast databases to AI, and this will certainly have an effect on the quality of the results that you will receive. Next, virtual reality and augmented reality. It will allow you to experience and visualize spaces like never before. And it usually takes the form of a 3D model. The user can wear a headset like the Apple Vision Pro and look at a virtual representation of a space. At the moment, its prohibitive cost means that it won't be used too widely, but as equipment gets cheaper and easier to use, it will take off. Augmented reality is already widely used for products. In this application, a 3D model of a product is built and can be placed in a real-world image. You can easily see this used for products such as furniture and accessories. You could take a photo of a wall and show it in different paint colors, for example. The next kind of AI is machine learning. Machine learning that can provide personalized recommendations to be specific. It helps you align your designs more closely with client tastes. Here, AI algorithms can analyze your client's preferences, style, and existing space to generate personalized design recommendations. By inputting information like color preferences, furniture style, room dimensions, the AI interior design tools can suggest furniture, decor, and color schemes that align with your client's taste, saving you time and ultimately resulting in you having a more satisfied customer. At the moment, this technology can be a bit clunky. I haven't seen any app that would fit my needs. It's not choosing the right kinds of products, for example. But as we can see, development in this area is moving very quickly. So probably soon it will have a wider variety of applications and products. The next type of AI is predictive analytics and the ability to predict design trends. AI can also analyze and predict design trends by analyzing data and helping you stay ahead of the curve. One area that is rapidly developing is the area of financial analysis. Soon, finance programs using AI will be able to help you improve accuracy, transparency, and efficiency. By analyzing large amounts of data, it can take into account material costs, labor expenses, and project complexity. AI-powered software will also be able to track and manage your project expenses. For example, linking your time tracking in real time and automatically updating cost data, comparing it to your existing budget and alerting you if there is a chance of potential cost overrun or any big budget deviations. AI algorithms can also provide you with detailed cost breakdowns that align with your project requirements, which have been given by your client and your own analysis, ensuring that your budget can stay on track. In addition, AI can analyze historical cost data and also industry trends to provide insights and recommendations for cost saving measures. So that's why you need to track your costs. By identifying areas of inefficiency and suggesting alternative materials and suppliers, you can optimize budgets while maintaining quality and the client's design goals. The next type of AI is streamlined communication and project management. If you're using Notion, for example, you'll see that AI is present there. AI can handle routine tasks and help you manage your projects more efficiently. It can be used from anything to planning out a blog post to helping you craft an email. You'll also have noted that generative AI is being integrated within many apps that you use. And this trend will only continue. Another common usage is chatbots and chat automations, helping customers that land on your websites by answering questions seamlessly. So the burning question is AI going to replace us? For the moment, the answer is no, from what I have seen. But AI will soon be able to generate images that are beyond the generic and the boring. But at the moment, it is certainly more successful in generating interiors that are minimal than it is in generating interiors that are more eclectic and have a more individualistic style. If you are a designer with a unique point of view and the ability to analyze the needs and work with clients and manage their projects, you will definitely stand out from any AI app. So now, tips for integrating AI in your workflow. So how can we leverage the power of AI? The first tip is to stay informed about AI and everything that it can do for the interior design industry. Newsletters such as Open Tools often showcase new apps. Then, once you find out about these tools, you should experiment them, integrate them into your workflow as much as possible, and see how you can speed up and improve efficiency. Leverage the power of automations in areas of things like budgeting and scheduling. And finally, be transparent with clients about how much you use AI in your workflow, emphasizing its efficiency and allowing you to lower your costs and do tasks more quickly. With any technology, there's going to be challenges and lessons to be learned. It's important to be aware of these limitations, but to use new technology to their fullest, enhancing your business. So, are you ready to leverage AI in your design business? If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and share. I'll be sharing a lot more videos about AI and how you can integrate it into your workflow. Thank you for watching this video. I'm here to help you build a more profitable and efficient interior design business. See you in the next video.